The next question is the Big Bang scientifically proven to be the origin of the universe?
Well, that all depends on what you pack into that word proven. If you mean some sort of mathematical proof or certainty, of course not. But you see, that's the very nature of science. Sean Carroll, who is a contemporary cosmologist, put it very nicely. He says, science isn't in the business of proving things. What it does is it furnishes explanatory models for phenomena, which are then assessed in terms of their explanatory power, explanatory scope, plausibility, fruitfulness in their predictions, and so forth. And I would say that the Big Bang Theory is the most successful model that exists today with regard to the evidence. It explains very well all of the evidence that we have, and there doesn't seem to be any evidence on the other side. In that same conference I mentioned, at which Vilenkin spoke at Cambridge, he was interviewed for a popular science magazine, and in this interview he said a remarkable statement. He said, all the evidence we have says that the universe had a beginning. Now that's a striking statement. He doesn't say the evidence for a beginning outweighs the evidence against a beginning. No, he doesn't say that. He says, all the evidence we have says that the universe has a beginning. There just isn't anything on the other side of the scale. So while the results of science are always provisional and susceptible to revision, nevertheless, I think that the person who believes in the beginning of the universe stands squarely and comfortably within the scientific mainstream today.